fellow Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen, do you believe a stranger can change your destiny?
Yes.
A stranger can do incredible things, such as changing our way of valuing people? Yes, I believe a stranger can change my destiny. I had the fortune of encountering such a stranger who enlightened me to think more positively about human nature. After 2 years working, I wanted to learn Italy and be a student again. That was the night I was writing a farewell letter to my parents and got ready to leave for a small town in Wisconsin, U.S. That night, that moment to my life, just like a bird, dusting his feather and getting ready to fly out of a cage and to really take a look around the world. However, I have no clue what will happen to me. My crystal ball didn't warn me. Actually, some breathtaking adventure will start right after my arrival. With my two fully loaded luggage, an important handbag, which carries all the money I need to fulfill my dream, I traveled very carefully and with a great anticipation until I arrived at a Chinese restaurant in Milwaukee. At that restaurant, a few students from Taiwan, including me, had our very first Chinese meal and our first fortune cookie. Ironically, the notes in the fortune cookie didn't give me any hint about my coming misfortune. When we were nearly done with our meal, I, on behalf of all the Taiwanese students, took out a rare animal from my important handbag and wanted to give to an international student advisor who came all the way to pick up us at the airport. Mother's Day, she didn't want to take it, so I had to convince him. So I chased him all the way to outside the restaurant and shoved the red envelope into his pocket. I got into the car and left with the car, never knowing I had left my wallet on the chair in the restaurant. On the way to the school, it was abnormally silent. Inside the car was deadly dark like a hell. I guess everyone was tired after a long flight. But I was awake, and I started to feel uneasy. After I got to the door, I dropped everything from my handbag. And I was so shocked to find out my wallet was gone. All my money was gone. I panicked. No one could help me at that moment. Someone even told me, Milwaukee? Oh, that city has the highest crime rate. It was too late to talk to anyone, but a representative from the Citibank with my trembling voice and broken English. I feel too miserable to sleep. And I talk to the God and pray over and over again throughout the night. With God's mercy, a miracle happened. The owner of the restaurant called and advised me the good news. A thin and young waitress from Laos saw my wallet and was not tempted by the amount of cashes and still returned it to me. When I met her, I gracefully bowed to her, and she gracefully smiled at me and waved as her way to serve our customer. With that experience, I feel so grateful to those strangers who enlightened me. With that unique experience and the defining moment, my starting in words turned to be the most wonderful and inspiring time in my life. That experience also helped me feel so grateful to those people who are passionate in helping others. That experience also helped me to believe that it's always a guardian angel beside me, even now. Some of you may think, we are now living in a war full of greed, lies, evil, hatred, even bloody conflicts. But somehow, there are so many beautiful people who are kind, honest, and with a fascinated heart. This world is certainly beautiful because of those beautiful strangers who are willing to show their benevolence and love to each other. I believe we Toastmasters all will be the beautiful strangers to others, like the waitress from Laos, like the special speaker, Les Miller from US, who can help us to make this world a wonderful place. Thank you.
Thank you, contest chair. Jenny gave us a very interesting speech today, talking about her beautiful stranger. She came out with attention. Let's get the audience attention. How did she do this? She did it with a question. She got the audience involved in her speech right away. This is point one in making a good speech. You must involve the audience. She developed the speech very well through a sequence of events, telling a personal story. And this personal story, you could tell, came from her heart. She was really feeling this story as she presented the story. So this is also a good way to involve the audience in the speech. Her conclusion was excellent. She showed us a very interesting way to bring in the philosophy throughout the whole story of her speech. Now, I want to talk a bit about presentation. I think that Jenny's presentation was very well prepared, and she used very good body language and gestures throughout her speech. However, for suggestions for improvement, I would like to make a couple of comments. Number one, she came out and, ladies and gentlemen, this I believe was overly dramatic. Too much gesture. Remember, gestures are to be used for emphasis in the speech. Second point, vocal variety. There were some times in her speech when she could have more effectively used pauses. Pauses are excellent to emphasize a certain point. In addition, she could have lowered her voice. For example, she looked at her bag. Oh my God, my wallet's gone. What can we do? So that is another effective way. Presentation point number three, eye contact. I noticed she scanned the audience here in the first few rows, but did you know we have a whole group of people up in the balcony that she didn't even make any contact with? She was not projecting her audience in the balcony. So that, I think, could be improved. Overall, Jenny had a very good speech. I liked the way she developed it. It was perfectly developed with no extra words. And with a few minor improvements, it could have been a superb speech. Contest chair.
Yes!
Thank
catching the audience's attention at the first 1 second is always the most important thing for a logical speech. Today, we have such a beautiful lady such a wonderful speech for us. At the very first beginning, I was very curious about who made her LV handbag here. So it suddenly drew my attention. And also, Jenny also asked two questions. She had interaction with the audience. So I would say she had a great opening, 30 points. There are two more parts that I like, which I thought she done very well in her speech. One part is the delivery skill. Because she mentioned that she panicked when she found that her body was lost. Actually, the way she delivered her speech, she didn't panic. You know, it's very hard to deliver a speech without any panic, especially in front of 700 people here. Even the Mr. Chi-Chi was nervous on the stage. So I would say, her delivery skill is wonderful. Good vocal variety, good voice, good pronunciation, and also excellent body language. 30 more points. The other one is the conclusion. Actually, she expanded the conclusion not only to the wallet, but also expanded to a higher level to love mankind. So I would say that was a very powerful and encouraging conclusion. Her message delivery was very clear, and I'm sure that after listening to her speech, nobody will steal the wallet. Actually, I think she has done very well enough today, so I don't have any suggestion for her. But only three parts that I think we can work on together for better performance. For one, at the very first beginning, she asked two questions. She built the familiar area with the audience. But actually, at her second question, nobody answered. So I would suggest her to have more confidence when she asks the second question. Part two. Through her speech, she looked a little too nervous and serious. I know losing body is not a good thing, but after, I think after you got the body back, you got everything back, you can give the audience a smile. You can give them a smile, let them know that you are not an excellent, not only an excellent speaker, but also a beautiful stranger. Last but not least, you mentioned the Mr. Champion, the world champion, in your conclusion. In fact, I would suggest you add some animals, add humorous elements in your speech. All in all, I hear your speech. I'm not sure that after listening to her speech, there would be no strangers in the world. God bless you.
Frankly speaking, I don't believe less changes. But it seems possible for me to believe in the beautiful changes here in Toastmaster Clubs. How much it, ladies and gentlemen? Do you believe in beautiful changes?
Yes.
This is the key message that our speaker, Jenny, would like to share with us today. I heard a lot of good qualities in her speech, which persuade me to believe in the beautiful strangers. And here I would like to offer what I have found in her speech. Number one, clear and simple. As you can tell, this is a very clear, very simple story with a clear message from the beginning until the end. Number two, constructive. She kicked off her story with a question, then follow story, and the end, she offered a findings here in Toastmasters Club. Number three, constructive. Control. She was so well controlled on stage. She controlled the property she used, and she controlled the message from the beginning until the end. However, as her evaluator, I would like to help her to think any possibilities to help her to pursue the excellence. And here, I would like three of my suggestions. Number one, to fully use the props. Since you put
asleep on the stage with a bag. Why not? To use sit on the stage, sit on the chair, or either to hold a bag on your hand to invite all the audience to follow you to enter the beautiful journey. Number two, a dramatic twist. Since this story is spans almost 6 minutes, why not add more props and pumps to pursue the excellent audience? We don't believe in love. If we could not believe in love, strangers, what would happen if we believe, and what might happen? Number three, to tell you a story. This story spend most of the time to share with us the story. It would be better if you tell your story a little bit and to add more stories happening Toastmasters and to share with us what unforgettable stories or experience happening Toastmasters and how these beautiful strangers in Toastmasters change your life totally. Also, I quite enjoy your speech remind me that I could believe in the beautiful strangers, but with wisdom. You are a speaker who is confident, who got a simple mind, and who is well controlled. If you could consider the skills I applied, I think you will be everybody's beautiful strangers in their life. Come this year.